Ladies and gentlemen, the arrival of us has been completed.
Thank you.
Our honored guest has just arrived. Ladies and gentlemen, announcing the arrival of Police Lieutenant General Rodel Sermonia, the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration. The arrival honor shall now begin. Lieutenant General Rodel Sermonia. He's being accompanied by Police Colonel Allegre Martinez, Pro-Overson Deputy Regional Director for Administration, with the company commander, Police Lieutenant Colonel Luis Gonzaga. Trooping the line is a long-time tradition in the Philippine National Police, which gives the guests of honor a chance to view the troops.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the arrival honors has been completed.
Hello,
Kinalapan din ako. Uy, nakakatawa naman yan mga ka-RC. Kakamoyan ko lang si Sir. Oo. Ito yung mga kasama ko sa Estel.
Okay, ba yan?
Okay, so doon muna mga ka-RC.
Okay, so retirement ka na? Yes, mayaman ka na.
Dito lang, sir, sa Cavite.
Kala ko na lang. Madali kay Buhos.
Ano lang, sir, sa Cavite. Sa full force kami.
Video.
Ito tayo ngayon sa Cavite Police Provincial Office. Sentimental journey. Legacy of Transparency and Public Trust. Police Lieutenant General Hotel Lord and Sarabon. The Deputy Chief PNP for Administration. So, nandun sila sa harap ng mga KRC. So, itong nandito sa site na ito, yung mga Chief of Police ng different cities and municipalities. Cavite PPO personnel sa site na to. Laki na ng improvement ng Cavite Police. Galing ako dito noon, wala pa itong gym na ito. Yan pa lang, wala pa ang bubuo. So, ayan, tunghayan po natin ang programa. Mag-uumpisa na.
A good life happens when you stop and are grateful for the ordinary moments that so many of us just dreamle over to try to find those extraordinary moments by Brené Brown. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Today we are gathered here for the sentimental journey for Police Lieutenant General Rodel Sermonia, the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration here at Computer General Pantaleon Garcia, City of Imus, Cavite. To begin with, may I request everyone to please rise and let us sing with honor and pride the Philippine National Anthem. Please remain standing for an invocation to be led by Police Lieutenant Colonel Hanji Alcaniete, Regional Pastoral Officer.
Let us now punish your presence. Almighty God, you are the source of all our achievements as Lord Mercers and public servants. We thank you and praise you for gathering us here in this Thanksgiving journey as we salute the outstanding achievements and memorable career of Lieutenant General, Police Lieutenant General Rodel O. Sermonia, the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration. Bless him and shower him with grace for his upcoming retirement in the service with love and support for his family and loved ones. May his legacy inspire and encourage every police officer to serve our institution with courage, honor, and integrity. Continue to bestow your grace to him and his family so they may have a fruitful, joyful, and productive life. May we be encouraged by your honoring for us to continue to strive towards the betterment of our organization and our nation. All this we ask in your mighty name, O God. Amen.
Please take your seat, sirs, ma'am. May we have now the Deputy Regional Director for Administration, Police Colonel Aligre Martinez, for the welcome remarks.
Good morning to everyone. Before I welcome remarks, marriage first, significant personalities for this day. First, the honoree, sir, the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration. Of course, the best of of our primary honoree, Madam Cherry Pai. Our second honoree, the Director of Directorate for Investigation and Detective Management, Major General Eric E. Noblesser. And the best half of our DIDM, Madam Cecilia. The Provincial Director of Cavite PPO, Colonel Leotero Ricardo. The representative of Heavenly Body of Bridges, Earth and Heaven, Reverend Father Henji Cañete. Cavite Provincial Police Office officers, PNCOs, non-uniform personnel, and other distinguished visitors of our honorees today. Isang mapagpalang araw sa akin. A warm welcome to this special occasion as we honor to honor and celebrate this sentimental journey for our two honorees, the DDCA and the DIDM, who will be introduced later. This day was made more significant as we gathered not just to recognize the extraordinary efforts and contributions of our distinguished and luminaries, but also to celebrate the successful journey of a fine and amiable police officers who brought pride and honor to our beloved organization, the Philippine National Police. We are indeed fortunate that, sirs, you have chosen our AOR as part of your sentimental journey. Maraming salamat, sir, for including in the list these places where you have rendered your duties with courage and dedication na aming minamana ngayon at sinusundan ng mga yapa. Our distinguished honorees have served our country with distinction, bravery, and unwavering commitment, earning the respect and admiration of all those who have had the privilege of serving alongside with them. And I am for sure those who have worked with him here in PRO Calabarzon. Sirs, marami akong nakita kanina na paganda yung ngiti nila as they have seen you. Ibig sabihin, you really have indeed performed your job well. For these reasons, you have so much and so good stories to tell about how once or how a great leader should be standing in front of our people. Your unwavering sense of duty, courage under fire, and leadership have been a source of inspiration to all of us still active and will be active in performing our tasks because of what you have laid down. Ang inyong contribution sa naging pag-unlad at pagyabong ng Philippine National Police ay hindi na mabubura sa kasaysayan at hinding-hindi namin kalilimutan. Ang inyong magandang aral at programa, gaya ng naipakita kanina, the transparency and public trust will be always written as one of your legacy. Sirs, we are hoping for your successful life and enjoyment of the fruits of what you have planted and nurtured. I hope that your future endeavors as you retire will be everything you have dreamed of that would have been. Congratulations, sirs, and thank you once again, everyone. Welcome and magandang umaga po sa atin.
Thank you very much, sir. And at this juncture, let's hear a message from Police Major General Eric Noble, the Director for Investigation and Detective Management.
DCA, Lieutenant General Samonia, Madam Cheripay, sa aking Mrs. Kelo Ricardo, Cardinal Martinez, and men and women of Cavite PPO. It's nice to be back, sir. Marami ng improvement. Dati, ano lang dito, eh, parang forest lang ito. Maraming, ano. So I was here 1995, 1996. Happy ako ng the old Dasmariñas Municipal Police Station. Ako lang official noon, tenyente pa lang ako. Kasi during those times, sir, maliit pa eh. So, our police station then was doon sa old Puriculture Center sa Dasmariñas, yung Walter Mark, tapos yung pagpasok mo papuntang munisipyo. Yung munisipyo, maliit pa lang. So, those were the days, parang nasa, ano ako noon, nasa, wala na akong matandaan eh, pero itong mga nakikita ko to, hindi ko na maalala, pero familiar faces, di ba? Panahon ni General Alasio, wala nang tandaan nyo. Ang esto noon, si Sir Kopong, di ba? So ako yung jefe. Ang aming governor noon ay unang-una si Publica, sir, yung unang panalo niya. So kami yung jefe ni Senator Kopong noon. Sa Dasmariñas noon, pupunti lang kami, siguro around 30 plus. Usually, ang checkpoint ko na lugar doon sa intersection ng papuntang Gentry at saka Emilio Aguinaldo, pagka may mga checkpoint kami dyan, doon parati kami. Or dito sa may boundary ng Imus, yung papuntang golf course. Kasi yung golf course noon, ginagawa pa lang. So those were the days. Yung Dasmariñas DBB, ang dami pang bakante, ang problema ko noon, marami ng dayo na pupunta. So, my mayor then was Mayor Kanimbuhan. Ang buhay namin noon, sir, napaka, ano, parang probinsya talaga. Kunti pa ang crime, kaibigan ko lahat ng mga kapitan. So, yung mga kapitan, pag kami nangyari krimen sa kanila, nahihiya pa sa hepe. My friend din si umakita maano pa si Kapitan Tana. Diba? Si Kapitan. So si Kapitan noon nagsusuri pa sa akin pagka hepe. Pasensya ka na, hindi natin nagwardiya. So those were the days, sir. Ang ganda ng aming mga samahan, old style rural policy. Hanggang na-experience ko pa, taas na ng pataas yung crime dahil marami ng dayo. So usually, ang term lang namin doon sa mga investigador ko noon, sila Sanchagel, kung ano yun, mga tao ni Gopri Mulya, noong araw, sila Mayor Ayong pa dito sa Imus, ang chief of police dito si then Captain Po sa Imus. Yan yung aking mga tropa dito sa gilid. Kasi ang noon sir, nung panahon namin sir, upland sa kanulan. So yung Bacoor, Dasmariñas, Imus, GMA hanggang doon. Kami yung magkaka tropa. Kasi dito ang krimen. Yung upland noon, napakatahimik. So, maganda yung Cavite PPO hanggang fast forward, ngayon, iba na yung mukha ng policy natin. Meron ng cyber world. Kahapon, nag-command conference kami at pababa ng pababa yung ating focus crimes. Pero pataas naman ng pataas yung cyber crimes. That's why ang ating ano ngayon, ang ating PNP ay nag-evolve na, no? So sa mga hepe, continue on with your training, your cybercrime investigators. Maganda yung ating statistics. Hindi na siya except doon lang sa mga significant or mga nagbabiral. The rest okay naman na yung ating outlook. Kaya lang sa pagdating sa cybercrime, doon na ngayon ang problema. So as I retire January 16, 10 days ahead ni DCA, ay yung challenge ang may payo ko sa mga younger officers, upcoming officers, mga magiging senior officers is to always study the landscape ng crime sa atin. Tuloy lang natin yung community engagement. Patuloy lang tayo magserbisyo sa ating mga kababayan, yung mga common tao, yung nandyan sa palipaligid. Let's be of service to them. Plus, ano na rin natin, more on cybercrime. Start familiarizing yourselves with the cyber-related crimes and the cyber core crimes. At ito ngayon ang challenge. Muli, maraming salamat sa honor na binigay niyo ngayon. Thank you, Cavite Police Provincial Office, sa men and women of Cavite PPO. Pagpatuloy niyo lang at ang mga mamamayan ng Cavite ay umaasa sa inyo. So, maraming salamat at mabuhay ang Cavite Police Provincial Office.
Thank you very much, sir. Before we proceed to the next part of our program, we would like to present a memento to Police Major General Eric Noble, and to present the memento is our Provincial Director. May we request Police Major General Eric Noble, sir, to please rise to receive the memento. Memento is the best of General Emilio Aguinaldo, the first president of the Philippines. Thank you very much, sirs.
And now to introduce our honoree, may we have our Provincial Director, Police Colonel Eleuterio M. Ricardo Jr.
To our guest of honor and speaker, who is well known to the men and women of Cavite Police Provincial Office, sir, accompanied with his very supportive wife, Mrs. Cherry Pai Ceremonial, the Director of for Investigation and Detection, Detective Management, Police Major General Eric E. Noblesor, together with his loving wife, Mrs. Cecilia Noblevan, our Deputy Regional Director for Administration, for A, Police Colonel Aligre Martinez, sir. Other Police Commission Officers, NCOs, and UPs, other guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is my pleasure to present to you our guest of honor and speaker, whom I know had played an integral part in the peace and order of this police provincial office. Together, let us witness through audiovisual presentation the inspiring and successful background of our guest of honor and speaker.
In his more than 37 years in the service, Police Lieutenant General Roden O. Sempoña embodies the quality of a well-rounded commander. Extensively built public support mechanism for the PNP through a collaborative partnership with different sectors in order to breed cooperation relative to the PNP squad function and operation, intelligence, investigation, and community relations. Our Deputy Chief PNP for Administration is a resolute advocate of community empowerment, a master of community mobilization and stakeholders engagement, with extensive experience in information development operations or IO, having been assigned both as former directors of the Police Community Affairs and Development Group, or PCADG, and the Directorate for Police Community Relations. When he assumed as the Director for Operations, or TDO, prior to becoming the Chief of the Directorial Staff last year, he busy-arised police operations by fusing operations with community relations to strengthen the PNP's narrative in war on illegal drugs, LTAC campaign, and in COVID response. General Sempoña is a member of the Philippine Military Academy, Makatao Class of 1989. He is a man who leads a life that follows the tradition of excellence. General Sempoña is a recipient of 3 most prestigious awards for government service. 3 times he was personally awarded by the President of the Republic of the Philippines. He was a judge as the Best Junior Officer of the Year in 2002, the second time since he won the same category in 1996. General Sempoña is also a recipient of the prestigious awards: the Metrobank Foundation Spots or Country's Outstanding Policeman and Now Outstanding Filipinos in the Service Award, and the most coveted award for PMA graduates, the 2004 PMA Cavalier Awards in 2004, and the Metrobank's Awards for Continuing Excellence in Service, or ACES, an award given every 5 years chosen from among the list of country's outstanding policemen, and twice awarded as HAB Awardee of the Civil Service Commission Presidential Goodbye Awards for the year 2016 and 2020. Our dear TDCA is twice finalist for the Civil Service Commission's Tangal ng Bayan Award and the Presidential Input ng Bayan Award in year 2004 and 2005 respectively. He is also a recipient of numerous military and police medals, making him up the Medal Officer. General Sempoña likewise was twice meritoriously promoted for risking his life and limbs in police operations against criminality and insurgency. First in 1997, when he was promoted to Chief Inspector, and secondly in 2002, when he was promoted to Police Superintendent. On October 2, 2022, with the guidance and approval of the Interior and Local Government Secretary Benjamin Avalos Jr., Lieutenant General Sempoña was designated as TDCA and Commander APC Visayas. Deputy Chief PNP for Administration, Police Lieutenant General Roden Orden Sempoña.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let us all welcome the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration, Police Lieutenant General Roden O. Sempoña.
Thank you. Maraming salamat to our generous host in today's activity, the Provincial Director of Cavite, Police Provincial Office, Police Colonel Lieutenant Ricardo Junior. Jun, ano nickname mo? Maraming salamat for that generous audiovisual presentation. Of course, let me acknowledge as well the representative of the regional director of PRO4A, soon to be Brigadier General Al Martinez. Thank you as well, Al, for the good words, kind words. Yung welcome mo, napakaganda. It's inspiring to both of us, ni Director DIDM. You've emphasized the legacy, the quality of work that we've done for the past 30 years in our career. So, salamat. Let me acknowledge also, baka magalit dito yung better half ko, lagi ko nakakalimutan. My one and only wife, Mrs. Jerify Sermonia, please stand. Siguro yung iba dito, nakikilala pa siya dahil dumadalaw din siya dati dito. Nung ako ay na-assign dito. And of course, my chief chaplain when I was the regional director of PRO3, Reverend Father Cañete. Hanggang ngayon, hindi ko mapan yung pangalan ni Father. Hank G. Ang hirap eh, di ba? Kakaiba. Hank G. Cañete. Of course, si Jan Noble and Cecil, thank you for joining us in today's activity. Very humble yan si Eric. Hindi niya kailangan yung siya yung sikat or kwan, kaya nakikita ko yung humility sa kanya. Sabi niya, sir, mag-join ako kahit na hindi ako yung main honoree doon. So thank you, Eric. You made this day even more meaningful because General Noble have worked with me as well as my deputy in the Police Community Affairs and Development Group, or PCRG that time. That was 2017 or 18. And he was also my deputy regional director in PRO3. Ayun, hanggang DPCR ata, nagkasama pa kami. Ex-officer siya sa DPCR. So lagi kaming magkasunod. Magkasunod din kaming mag-retire next month. He will be retiring January 16 and 10 years after, 10 days. Ako naman yung magre-retire, that will be January 26. So, alam na natin kung anong reason kung bakit kami nandito. It is our sentimental journey in our service. And we really plan for it to visit all the offices na kung saan kami nanggaling. And again, to the gallant men and women, snappy personnel, including non-uniform personnel of Cavite Police Provincial Office, led by your indefatigable and snappy Provincial Director, Colonel Ricardo Jr. Maraming salamat sa warm welcome ninyo. Palakpakan ninyo ang sarili. Of course, before I will proceed with my, I don't know kung long ito o gusto pang pahabain, kasi pag ako ay nag-adlib, mas mahaba. Pag ako ay nagkwento, mas mahaba lalo. But I'd like to acknowledge the presence of the personnel that I've worked with more than 22 years ago. Actually, mag 23 years na. And I'm very happy that there are still few who are still working in active service. Dalawa to, nakita ko. Si, ewan ko, ate ba to? Or mas matanda? Siguro ate. Si Ate Hilda. Yeah, palakpakan natin si Ate Hilda. Kasama ko yan sa S2. Nandiyan din si Ate Annie. Yan. Ate ba tawag ko sa'yo? Ate rin. Kasi sabi mo, magre-retire na rin sila. And of course, ang ate ng lahat. Si Ate Esther. Ate Esther, maraming salamat. Sila po yung mga personnel ko sa PIIB at that time. Alam niyo PIIB? Provincial Intelligence and Investigation Branch. At S2 pa. Ngayon, ano nang pangalan ngayon ng S2? Intelligence Division. Let me acknowledge, of course, si ang aking deputy when I was the Chief of Police of Dasmariñas. And now, sabi ko sa kanya, talagang mahal na mahal mo maging deputy. Si Lieutenant Colonel Jan Buruga. Yeah. A member of Class 98. Sino pa ba? Of course, may mga 98 din dito. Tatlo ang Class 98 ang nagpwede dito. Hindi lamang si Colonel Ricardo, kundi si Colonel Olazo, the Iron Man Cup. Kalaban ni Jun Plana. Iron Man. Kung ako ay tinatawag na Iron Man General kasi kasabay ko siya na nag-triathlon at Iron Man during our time. I don't know kung ginagawa pa niya dahil medyo parehas na kaming lumaki ng katawan. He's one of the best provincial directors as well. And another provincial director na naging tao ko rin ay si Police Colonel Marlon Santos. Also a member of Class 98. Snappy talaga mga 98. And of course, I have with me my senior executive assistant, si Police Colonel Francis Ebrio. Yan, Francis. My executive assistant sa lahat ng mga pinupuntahan ko, itong si Professor Mike Silva. Hindi siya bago dito. Mike Silva, actually dito ko siya nakilala. Dahil kay Tata Bert Silva of DZRH. Yan. Siguro batang-bata pa siya noon. May tumatango doon. Ngayon, yung aking inanak siya, si Edwin Soto. Edwin, tayo ka. Naanak ko sa kasal to. Nag-retire ka na pala. Yan, mga tao ko sa Dasmariñas. Nandito rin si Major Ernesto Caparas Jr. Please stand. Yan, mga nakasabay ko dito. Of course, ang isa sa mga staff ko sa S2. Hanggang ngayon, S2 pa rin ba? Hindi. Si Major Allen Lim. Allen, thank you. Kami yung mga video makakasama. Si Captain Norman Cachao, yan, nakasama ko rin. Noon ay yung patrolman ang PO1, PO2 pa lang sila noon. Nandito rin si retired, and surprise, nag-retired na to, si Glenn Pandalan, ang aking tagagawa ng
sir, ito ako, sir.
Briefing. Yan si Glenn, magaling gumawa to ng mga PowerPoint presentation. Then, si ang aking mga magagaling na SWAT. Ha? SWAT or sila yung tagapatay ko ng mga kriminal. Nandito si, sino ba to? Si Glenn. Ano? Glenn. Eh, asan si Glenn? Nawala? Nagtago? Sergeant Belio. Yeah. Si Glenn, saan si Glenn? Nagtago? Nandyan, nandyan kanina. Si Danilo Noveno. Ayan. Mga tao ko sa SOG, kasama ni General Leo Francisco, NS2. Si Major or Kapitan, dati kong Chief Investigator, si Major Reyes, sabag na Reyes. Yeah, thank you. It's nice to see you. Still in good shape. Then, nandyan si Isagami Lee. Yeah. Ernesto Olaes. Si Alfredo Paredes, hindi ko na babanggitin yung mga rangko nyo, ha? Rolando Galve. Wala. Ah, nabanggit ko na so si Edwin Soto, si Glenn Jones. Nawala. Malis. Hector Clibacosa, another SWAT. Yan. Oscar Diana. Ayun. Estrella, si Ate Esther na to. Si Ate Hilda Vallarta, si Ate NUP Gragasin, Emmanuel Sayuno, ayun, si Puyang, si Marlon, of course. Marlon, nice to see you again. Wala na yung partner mo? Si ba yun? Magkaisa? Ayun, nawala. Wala na. And alam niyo, marami rin tayong mga colleagues dito. Hindi nyo na siguro sila naabutan yung mga magagaling na tao natin. The Moral Brothers, lalo na si Captain Jun Moral. Captain ba siya o nagwan?
Inspector.
Inspector. Sila yung mga naging kasamahan ko dito 22 years ago. So, to everyone, magandang umaga sa ating lahat. I stand before you this morning with overwhelming nostalgia as I reminisce my journey in this career in the Philippine National Police.
towards my concluding retirement next month. I thank you for the opportunity to be joined once again by the outstanding personnel who work with me in dealing with the challenges I have had during my decade-long stint in Cavite Province. Hindi naman isang dekada, kundi almost lang. Kasi 2001 to 2007. Pero bumalik pa ata ako dito eh. Actually, dalawang beses akong bumalik dito. And to the people who nurtured me and helped me grow in my career and in my personal life. Sa inyong lahat na matagal kong nakasama, sa S2, nabanggit ko na yung mga pangalan ninyo, or PIIB, at mga nakasama ko sa Cavite City, na no, ang kauna-unahan na nag-hepe ako, I was then a major, kahit Lieutenant Colonel ang dapat na nandun, they gave me a break and tested me if I can prove myself to be worth as a city chief of police in Cavite, that was 2001. Mga nakasamahan ko rin sa Dasbariñas Police Station, hindi pa siya siyudad noon, but it is one of the most populated municipalities in the entire country. Kasi almost 1 million na noon ang kanilang population, napakarami. And now, it is already a lone district of Dasbariñas City. And Dasbariñas City used to be also as the murder capital of the entire country sa lahat ng municipalities because almost every day ay may mga patayan. Alam yan ni Captain Reyes, tama? At ni Colonel Uruga. Then, of course, nag-hepe rin ako for a while sa Bacoor City. In addition to my duties as the chief of the PIIB. Challenging because it was during the election period when I became the chief of police of Bacoor City. So, ang pagpunta ko po dito ay talagang yung pagkakataon para personal na magpasalamat sa mga nakasama ko dito 20 years ago or 22 years ego, napakahabang panahon. To Colonel Ricardo, the current PD of Cavite PPO, you are the third na class 98 na nakasama ko na naging PD dito. Puro lahat is snappy. So I know that Cavite PPO is also in good hands under your leadership because that is the standard of PNPA class 1998. Palakpakan natin siya. And of course, during the time of Colonel Olaso, I was supposed to visit him during the BIDA program, but it was overtaken by events. Nagpalit bigla, so hindi po natuloy. But I'm pretty sure that the BIDA program now here is being implemented properly. That every policeman must know the Buhay Ingatan Droga Ayawan program, a brainchild of our SILG. And indeed, a brilliant program that will hopefully finally end our number one problem, which is illegal drugs, if we know how to implement the program. It is actually anchored on whole of the nation approach. So, at this point, I indulge everyone to allow me to be sentimental a little bit in this sentimental journey. Nung ako ay na-assign dito almost 10 years, I've served with several provincial directors. It is unprecedented for an intelligence officer to serve with four different provincial commanders or directors. Kasi usually, pag esto ka, pag iba yung PD, pinapalitan. It was a time, during the time of General Pagdilaw, General Boyce Rosales, General Bernhardi Mantele, and General Fidel Posadas. Tama ba? Sila yung mga nag-provincial director dito. And I had also the opportunity, as I said earlier, to be a chief of police of major cities. Cavite City, during my time, it was awarded as the best WCP region-wide and one of the best police stations. And we have introduced major breakthroughs in Cavite City that is now being implemented nationwide. In Cavite City, we started the Bahay Pagbabago and we started the Bahay Pag-asa. Yung Bahay Pag-asa, Kalinga. Bahay Kalinga, it is a center or halfway center for battered wife and abused children. Yung mga yun. So nakita nila yung template na yan, it was replicated by now different stations. And we also started a halfway center for those who voluntarily surrendered na gumagamit ng droga. Ang tawag namin doon ay Bahay Pag-asa. So, these both centers was operationalized in the spirit of volunteerism without any funds coming from the government and in particular the Philippine National Police. It was supported by the different stakeholders, by the local government units, and other well-meaning and generous, kind-hearted kababayans. So tumatakbo siya in the spirit of volunteerism. And I'm very happy that that program or this program is now replicated in some parts of our country. When I was a chief of police of Dasmariñas, we started a program that was also replicated in other parts, but in a different way. If you still remember, yung shame campaign rally natin. We have done that in Bataan, when I was a provincial director of Bataan, that made a big role in making Bataan province the first drug-cleared province nationwide during the time of the Duterte administration. And in Dasmariñas, when we did that, of course, we are not that prepared. I may not be that prepared at that time because I was still a young lieutenant colonel. Siguro hindi ko pa kayang influence yung mas maraming tao. But that template started in Dasmariñas. At marami rin nag-surrender. Pumunta kay judge, pumunta kay mayor. Pero I cannot remember if we established a Bahay Pagbabago or Pag-asa. But we did a lot of major breakthroughs as well. Like the establishment of JIPCO, the Joint Industrial Peace Concern Office, started here in Cavite PPO. A program wherein we work together with the different industries and economic zones para mawala yung infiltration ng CPP and PA left-leaning groups in the labor sector. At para maproteksyonan din sila sa mga hijacking, sa ano yung ginagawa sa microchips, field brains, and other criminal activities in these different economic zones. And we have duplicated that in the province of Bataan when I was a provincial director. And it was replicated now in different areas. I think we have also started a major breakthrough program. Yung ating recovery and wellness program, as I mentioned earlier, through our Bahay Pag-asa in Cavite City. And dito rin natin nagawa yung mga napakarami nating accomplishments. if you're attentive in the AVP, all the major awards na nakuha ko as a police officer, like the Metro Bank Outstanding Policeman, Cavalier Award for PMA Graduates for Police Operations, Junior Officer of the Year for the second time nationwide, Best Police Station for Las Marinas nationwide, dito lahat nangyari. Dahil marami kaming mga operations, alam niya na mga kasamahan ko dito, yung mga buwis buhay na tinatawag natin ng mga operations natin. At that time, parang maraming problema sa criminality, but because of major breakthrough, we encountered kidnap for ransom groups na tumakas pa sa Pacer nung araw. If you still remember, sila Marahumsar, yung mga Marines, sila Patinio, sila Radam, in Magallanes, Cavite, that made a major breakthrough as well. And at the same time, yung ating pag-rescue ng isang kidnap victim in General Trias, where no less than the President of the Republic of the Philippines went there for a press conference on site. It was also during our time when we neutralized the Corotong Belleg, yung kanilang mga, anong tawag natin sa kwan? Other members of the Corotong Belleg here in Bacoor. And another big gangs involved in holdups in Paliparan, Cavite. Doon na imulatan na naman ng mga ating SWAT team yung pitong namatay. And of course, another breakthrough na pwede natin pag-usapan or reminisce is our accomplishment in neutralizing the Central Committee of the CPP-NPA. If you remember, we arrested Tagaytay 5, sila Camoris, Aristides Sarmiento. Kung hindi natin sila na-neutralize, they were planning a big, big rally, mobilizing millions of people from Southern Tagalog to overthrow, to topple the presidency of GMA during the Labor Day 1. But 2 days or 3 days before their execution plan, we were able to utilize them in Tagaytay. And that is the infamous Tagaytay 5. And another program or major accomplishments that we have done here with the Cavite PPO is the neutralization of the leader of Alex Bungkayaw Brigade, yung hitman nila. Ito si sino ba to? Camoris. Tama ba? Camoris. So si Camoris is the hitman of the CPP-NPA Sparrow Unit. Ayan. And, of course, yung kasamahan niya, nawala na ako sa aking kwan dahil hindi ko na binasa, ay yung political officer nila. So, those are the major breakthroughs, programs, operational accomplishments of the Cavite Police Provincial Office when I was assigned here. It made Cavite PPO as one of the best provincial offices nationwide because of the gallant men and women that I've worked with here at nandyan po sila. Palakpakan ninyo ang inyong mga seniors and I'm very happy to see them. And one of the reasons why I'm here also, even though I'm retiring, General Noble and I would like to leave a legacy that must not be forgotten by every member of the Philippine National Police. Ito yung legacy na gusto namin iwan. Na dapat intindihin ninyo at gawin ninyo. A legacy of transparency, integrity, accountability for us to be able to win public trust. Diba? Public trust. Diyan papasok yung community engagement. And as I look forward for my retirement next month, I shall not rest a day until my last day in Philippine National Police to drive to your hearts and minds this legacy, which is transparency, integrity, accountability, and public trust that I want to see being practiced by our police commanders way beyond my retirement. And of course, our men and women in all levels of the different units of Philippine National Police. The brand, transparency, integrity, and public trust is no accident by name. It was well thought to reflect the ideals and values that I want everyone to embrace. Hindi ito chamba-chamba o inembento lang. Sa aking huling opisyal na pagbisita sa Cavite PPO, nais kong iwan ang magandang aral ng karanasan na sana'y magsilbing inspirasyon at gabay ninyo sa inyong paglalakbay sa inyong profesyon. Lalong-lalo na yung mga matatagal pa sa serbisyo, and of course to our commanders in the different municipalities and cities. But before I proceed with my message, I'd like you to watch this audiovisual presentation para mas maintindihan nyo kung ano itong sinasabi ko na legasiya na gusto kong iwanan sa inyong lahat. Pakiplay.
The continuing outbursts of public outrage towards the involvement of some police personnel in some incidents of abuses and misconduct has prompted the BNP leadership to decisively come up with efficient strategies in order to proactively address issues that leads to the erosion of public trust and confidence to the police. Such irregularities within the ranks have triggered loose waves of dissatisfaction and distrust towards the PNP, as reflected in various social media posts that gave rise to negative public opinions on the police that no less than President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. had noticed.
Mark my words, there will be no room for leniency for those who engage in acts that tarnish the reputation of our police and jeopardize.
The Philippine National Police categorically reiterates its stand that it does not condone atrocities committed by its few misguided members. The BNP deems these operational blunders are unforgivable and a tangible example of the ultimate betrayal of people's trust and the organization's mandate.
Amidst the many challenges faced by your institution, I expect you to always lead by example and ensure that every officer and every personnel under your command adheres to the highest standards and that we have set forth.
In response to public clamor and the leadership guidance of the President, the Philippine National Police, through the efforts of the Deputy Chief of PNP for Administration, Police Lieutenant General Rodel Orden Sermonia, launched a nationwide massive engagement of police commanders down to provincial and station units based on the directive of President Marcos Jr. to uphold moral ascendancy, integrity, transparency, and accountability of every police personnel.
Well, I police more than 30 years na. Kung ako po ang tatanungin, masasabi kong ito ay mali
campaign, dubbed as Transparency and Integrity Program Caravan, has provided the PNP with an engagement platform to systematically address different issues affecting public trust and create different venues of a stronger collaborative partnership between the PNP and the civil society for a whole-of-nation approach for the massive and intense reiteration of all PNP guidelines on internal disciplinary mechanism, police operational procedures, and the doctrine of command responsibility. TIE Caravan highlights a variety of programs such as Talk to Men, a tech talk to personnel facing administrative charges, command guidance to all PNP commanders, beginning from area police command down to all city and municipal unit commanders. Part of the DIP engagements are crash course lectures on the PNP's internal disciplinary mechanism, particularly the methods of implementation of the three phases of the strategic internal cleansing program of the PNP, namely preventive, where the moral fiber of every police personnel are consistently being strengthened to make them resilient to corruption, abuses, and all forms of misconduct that tarnish the reputation of the PNP to the public. Punitive, where the PNP decisively exercises its resolve to purge its own ranks of misfits and its counterparts. And restorative, where police personnel with standing administrative cases for minimal offense are being restored through retrainings and reorientation of PNP's doctrines, policies, and guidelines. As it was the desire of the President for the PNP to become an instrumentality of good governance, to bring the organization closer to the communities, and to foster stronger partnership for peace and security, the Transparency and Integrity Program further extends its engagement to civil society groups, anti-crime and anti-corruption advocacy groups, faith-based groups, and the likes to promote public support, appreciation, and cooperation to the ongoing PNP strides towards internal cleansing. In August 16, 2023, acting on the directive of PNP Chief Police General Benjamin Acuña Jr., and the Interior and Local Government Secretary Benjamin Abalos Jr., DDCA General Sermonia kicked off the Transparency and Integrity Program at the Area Police Command Southern Luzon, Police Regional Office 4A and 4B, and in BRO 5, attended by 300 PNP personnel, 150 advocacy support groups, and 257 PNP personnel. 2 days after, he visited the National Capital Region Police Office at Camp Bagong Diwa, Bicutan, Taguig City. This was followed by the ABC Northern Luzon and Police Regional Offices 1, 2, 3, and Cordillera. Central Visayas also showed massive support to the program with the presence of all its police provincial offices. 144 hearing personnel were present during said visit. Quezon, Laguna, and Batangas Police Provincial Offices were also visited on August 31 and September 1 with overwhelming attendance of advocacy support group members and local government officials. In the following months, Area Police Command Western Mindanao, Police Regional Offices 9, 11, 12, and Bangsamoro Autonomous Region were visited to promote DIP between and among PNP and its supportive community leaders and local government units, all for the purpose of creating a viable partnership to achieve peace and development and good governance. The Transparency and Integrity Program Caravan was also the first ever NHQ land program implementation that reached Tawi-Tawi province in the southern frontier of the Philippines. As we look forward to the success of the Transparency and Integrity Program, all PNP units, in partnership with the national and local stakeholders and other advocacy support groups, will continue to work hand-in-hand in demonstrating to the public the PNP's sincere commitment towards its internal disciplinary mechanism,
has shown in his timely responses and actions on complaints lobbied at the Sumbunyong Action Academy via the Complaints Referral and Monitoring Center. The Transparency and Integrity Program is the BNP's antidote to the eroding trust and confidence of the public to the police. The continuity and its eventual success will be testament of legacy and commitment to good governance of General Acorda and General Sermonia, being the chief of BNP and the number two man of the BNP respectively towards the realization that is capable, professional, and responsive to the needs of the communities we serve and protect.
Ladies and gentlemen, gallant men and women of Cavite Police Provincial Office, that is a program or a legacy that we want to leave to all of you. We're here to remind you of three major policies of Transparency, Integrity, Accountability Program. Three major policies. First, our internal disciplinary mechanisms. Tandaan natin, love you. The internal disciplinary mechanism composed of three stages: preventive, punitive, and restorative. Preventive, doon pa lang, sa recruitment ay talagang salang-salana. Kaya meron tayong tinatawag na nameless and faceless at walang palakasan. Being the chairman of the recruitment board, chairman of the lateral entry board, napakaraming tumatawag sa akin. Closest to me, tumatawag rin sa akin kung pwedeng matulungan. Pero kung hindi pumasa, hindi talaga pwede. Alam niyo sinong closest to me? Ang aking missis. Kasi marami rin tumatawag sa kanya. Sabi ko, hindi talaga papasa. Ipasa mo muna lahat ng stages ng recruitment sa walang palakasan. That alone is a preventive aspect para hindi tayo mahaluan. Diba? Kahit sino mga senator, governor, mga malalakas dyan, mga bilyonaryo, kung hindi talaga papasa, hindi pwede. Kasi napakaraming aplikante. And punitive, we have mechanisms as well. We have the IAS, we have PLEB, we have the NAPOLCOM, we have the DILOS, we have the criminal courts, those who violates criminal acts. And if you are given chance, probably the one that had happened in Imus, Cavite, where some of our personnel violated a lot of our police operational procedures, if they are given the chance, meaning to say, they are not recommended for dismissal, at sila ay magiging suspended lang, demoted lang, meron tayong restorative, di ba? Para bibigyan sila ng pagkakataon na magbagong buhay. Maging matino, maayos, at mahusay na miyembro ng Philippine National Police. That is our internal disciplinary mechanism na dapat natin palaging tatandaan. And another policy under Transparency and Integrity and Accountability Program is the police operational procedures. A lot has been violated by members of the Imus Police when they did an operation to allegedly drug personality. And yung police operational procedures natin, hindi lamang sa actual operation. Investigation, may mga operational procedures din. Even in intelligence activities. And now, in police community relations activities, meron na rin police operational procedures na tinatawag under these squad functions. And pinaka-importante, lalong-lalo sa mga supervisors, whether you are a PNCO or a PCO, especially the station commanders, the chief of police, yung doctrine of command responsibility. We're not going to spare anyone. If your people will commit mistake and you are not instituting or doing actions against their infractions, the commanders and supervisors themselves will be dealt with accordingly. They are going to be punished as well. So simple lang ang lagi natin tatandaan with this legacy that we wanted to leave. Diba? Napaka-importante. Dapat, una, isa puso ang paglilingkod. Ang pagiging kagawad opisyal ng PNP ay hindi isang hanap buhay. Tandaan natin. Napakaswerte natin dahil nadoble na nga ang sweldo natin. Noong kasagsagan ng pandemya, lahat or halos lahat ng mga kababayan natin, kahit mga negosyante, ay nawalan ng hanap buhay. Pero tayo, ng mga pulis, napakaswerte kasi yung sweldo natin ay tuloy-tuloy. And we even had the chance of giving genuine service to our kababayans in times of the most disastrous incident that happened in our lifetime, which is COVID-19, di ba? Yan ang siguro pinakamalala na nangyari sa buhay natin. Pero we had that opportunity to shine, di ba? We did very, very well. But we are lucky as well dahil tuloy-tuloy ang sweldo natin. Kaya huwag niyong gawing hanap buhay ang pagiging pulis. Hindi mo ginagawa ang isang bagay dahil lamang sa may sarili kang kapakinabangan. Gawin mo ito dahil alam mo sa puso at isipan mo na ito ang makakapagbago sa buhay ng mga taong sinumpaan mong paglilingkuran at protektahan. Remember the words, compassion, empathy. Huwag mong maging maramot sa pagtulong, maging mapagmalasakit sa kapwa, lalo na sa mga taong walang kapangyarihan ipagtanggol ang kanilang karapatan sa batas at lipunan. Tandaan natin ito. Iilan-ilan lang kayo dito, but you have to share this to your colleagues, to your subordinates. Pangalawa, sundin ang tagubuilin ng ating Pangulo. Ang sabi ng Pangulong Bongbong Marcos sa PNP, the cornerstone of effective law enforcement is public trust and community engagement. Doon sa mga opisyal na fighting the problem or sa mga pulis na fighting the problem, mga opisyal na ayaw sa PCR o mag-isip, isip ulit kayo bakit mas nais bigyan ng diin ng ating presidente ang public trust at mas matimbang sa kanya ang police community relations kaysa sa mga statistics ng accomplishments in terms of operations, investigations, and intelligence. Mas gusto pa niya ng police ay maging agent of positive change. Diba? Positive change. So, in one of the speeches of the President, challenge niya ang ating organisasyon to become agents of positive change. Ang ibig sabihin nito, dapat bawat isa sa atin maging instrumento ng good governance. Tandaan natin. Bawat isa sa atin ay maging instrumento ng good governance. Walang gagawa ng kalokohan ng mga illegal activities. To give no rooms for leniency to those who engage in acts that tarnish the reputation of our police and jeopardize safety of our people. Ang ibig sabihin nito, ipakita natin yung sinseridad natin sa taong bayan that we are truly policing our ranks. Nililinis natin ang ating hanay. Remember at all times, we are servants of the public. And again, hindi tayo ang Panginoon sa kalsada. Hindi natin kailangan yung mga abusadong pulis na nagsisiga-sigahan at tine-terrorize ang mga miyembro ng komunidad. Keep integrity at all times and remain steadfast in commitment to public service amidst the many challenges faced by the institution. Ang ibig sabihin naman nito, mahalagang itaguyod natin ang tiwala ng taong bayan upang maging kapanipaniwala ang lahat ng mga sinasabi natin. Again, keep in mind of public trust. Yung bang lahat ng resulta ng operations, intelligence, and investigation na ginagawa ninyo ay katanggap-tanggap at kapanipaniwala sa taong bayan? Or, ito ba ay tantad ito ng cognitive resonance? O yung ibig sabihin, hindi magkatagba ang sinasabi natin sa nakikita at nararamdaman ng ating mga kababayan. Sinabi mo, bumaba ang crime incidents. Sinasabi natin, napakarami natin nahuhuling drug personalities. Sinasabi natin na wala nang mga hold-upan dyan. Pero hindi yan ang nararamdaman at nakikita ng ating mga kababayan. So dapat, totoo ang ating ilalahad sa ating mga kababayan. Uphold the highest standard of ethics, professionalism, and compassion for human rights. Ibig sabihin, huwag natin gamitin ang ating otoridad, ang ating badge, ang ating uniforme, at baril para sa sariling kapakanan o sa pang-aabuso sa kapwa at sa ating tungkulin. And lead by example. Ibig sabihin, tayo mismo ang dapat paghugutan ng inspirasyon at motivation ng ating mga kasama sa pagiging huwarang lingkod ng bayan at tagapamayapa sa komunidad. Hindi yung tayo pang mga pulis ang dumadagdag o ang sanhi ng galit ng taong bayan sa ating organisasyon or for that matter, in the entire government. Kasi kung may pulis na nakasala, kagaya ng nangyari sa Imus Cavite, galit na galit ang ating mga kababayan sa ating gobyerno. Di ba? Hindi dapat tayo ang pag-uugatan o pagsisimulan ng galit ng mga taong bayan sa ating gobyerno. Kundi tayo dapat ang maging agents of positive change. Di ba? So we have to lead by example. Idagdag ko dito yung lagi kong sinasabi. Nung ako ay chief of police, nung ako ay provincial director, regional director, and even in all my command visits all over the country, I always tell the commanders, especially the chief of police, the provincial directors, and the regional directors, na dapat tayo mga director or commanders ay 99% ang ginagawa natin supervision at 1% lang ang instruction, hindi yung puro utos, hindi mo naman sinusupervise at ini-ensure na ginagawa yung mga programa kagaya ng Transparency and Integrity Accountability Program at kagaya ng mga iba't ibang mga anti-criminality programs natin, ang ating BIDA programs, ang ating mga iba't ibang police community relations programs. Napakaraming magagandang programa ng Philippine National Police. Hindi na natin kaya mag-isip pa. Pero sa mga commanders na iiwanan namin, including our provincial directors, future regional directors, dapat lagi nating tandaan, 99% supervision and 1% instruction. Huwag puro utos. Upuan ninyo, mga tao ninyo. Don't be just an aircon commander or nasa opisina lang. Be a mentor. share your expertise and experiences. But of course, you cannot share anything if you don't know anything. You cannot share your experiences if you're just staying in the comforts of your air-conditioned offices. Young officers do come and go at kailangan ng mga papalit na bagong opisyal na matuto. Teach them the values of public trust and community engagement. Bringing our police closer to the community, fostering partnership for peace and security. At ito ang pinakahuling tagubilin ko sa inyo. Kagaya ng sinabi ko, a legacy that we want to leave to all of you. Embrace this program, Transparency, Integrity, Accountability Program. Because we will always be confronted by challenges. Kung itong three major policies na to ay hindi naiintindihan, hindi inilalagay sa puso, at hindi ini-implement ng mga tao natin. We will always be confronted with challenges kung hindi ito maiintindihan at isa sa puso at i-implement ng mga tao natin. This is our antidote to the eroding public trust and confidence in our organization. Let us work together in promoting collaborative partnership to continuously sustain the wide support of the public to the PNP. As the President prescribes what the PNP should be doing at all times, I indulge our commanders to personally lead our lower units to promote different platforms of collaborative partnership with the community to facilitate stakeholders' involvement in the PNP's internal cleansing drive and our collective quest towards good governance. At ang pinakahuli na dapat natin gawin, dahil ito ay ginagawa ko rin, ang pakiusap ko sa inyo sa ikaganda ng ating paglilingkod sa ating bayan, especially mga commanders natin, keep an open door policy. Open door policy. This is a jumping board of transparency and eventually gaining public trust. This is how you showcase empathy and compassion not only amongst ourselves but among our citizens. Nung ako ay director ng Police Community Relations Group, literal na nakabukas lagi ang aking opisina para sa lahat. Because I am transparent. When I became the regional director of Region 3, ganun din ang aking inaugural speech. I announced them that my office will be open 24/7 and it will be literally an open door policy. Medyo chinalis ko yun sa sarili ko. Kaya ko bang gawin to? Nagawa ko. Kasi I have very good staff. Nandun si Mrs. Bars, nandun sa ako mga secretary, at doon na rin natutulog. May tulugan kasi ako sa office ko. Kaya, it is literally an open door policy. But, I always do that in all my assignment. And I'm now the Deputy Chief PNP for Administration, the number 2 man of the Philippine National Police. Hindi mo kailangan humingi ng appointment. Pag nandun ako, kahit patrolman ka, kahit civilian ka, if I have time, I will always listen to you and entertain how to give assistance to you. Nung ako ay general na, director ako ng Police Community Relations Group, ang hirap makipag-appointment sa mga members ng komando. Di ba, Eric? Parang nagdadalawang isip pa ako bilang a one-star general if I'm going to see the members of the command group, lalong-lalo siguro kay Chief PNP at that time. kasi kailangan mo magpa-appointment. That's why I made it a mantra na kahit sinong pupunta sa opisina ko, nandun naman ako, haharapin ko yan. Kung hindi ko man maharap ng matagal, baka sabi lang na hi, hello, good morning, pero bago kong gagawin yon, dapat lahat ng mga staff ko ay na-aksyonan na lahat yung kanilang mga idinudulong na mga issues and concerns. And that is what I want all the commanders to do. Wala mang written orders yan. But I encourage you to do that. Hepe kayo, make it as an open door policy. Entertain everyone. Extend assistance sa abot ng makakaya ninyo. Wala naman mawawala sa atin. And in that way, I hope and I envision that the Philippine National Police will be one of the most trusted agency of the government if we are capable, highly professionalized, respected by the public, believed by the public. And in that way, there's no reason that we'll be able to gain the trust and confidence, that we'll be able to win the hearts and minds of the people we sworn to protect. And if we will be able to win the hearts and minds of the people, the trust and confidence of the public, there's no reason that we are not going to be successful in our work or job as a police officer, specifically in our fight against all forms of criminality, illegal drugs, literally ending the local communist armed conflict, and even in doing police community relations activities by giving assistance to those who are in need, if the people will work with us. And of course, every done will be executed through a whole of the government approach and whole of the nation approach. Kasi nandun na yung iba't ibang agencies, nandun na yung iba't ibang members ng civil society because we were able to gain their trust and confidence. So there's no reason that we will achieve yung ating inaasam-asam na long-lasting peace, di ba? And public order. So with that, again, to the gallant men and women of the Cavite Police Provincial Office, to my colleagues, more than 22 years ago, majority of them, if not all, are all retired. Maraming salamat for this opportunity. It's been really a very wonderful day for me and to my co-honoree, General Eric Noble, to meet all of you again. And please, don't forget the program that we want or the legacy that we want to leave to all of you. Please share that to your comrades, to our colleagues, in the entire Cavite PPO. Maraming salamat. May God bless us all. Mabuhay ang Cavite PPO. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all of you.
Thank you very much, sir. We will now proceed to the presentation of memento to our honored guests. Once again, Mayor Lucrez, Police Colonel Aligre Martinez, Pro Calabarzon Deputy Regional Director for Administration, together with our Provincial Director to present the memento. May we request our honored guests to please rise to receive the memento. Our memento is the last agenda of the first president of the Philippines. Then that sort of led her reminder of the great liberals uniting either Father Bushma and taking the Calvinist independence. Provincial Motor Corps Company is a good employee.
One more shot. Yes, Mike. Okay. One, two, three.
Thank
you. Sir, upload ko sa vlog ko to, sir, ha? Buo to, sir. Walang putol.
Sa vlog?
Yes, sir.
Vlog
ko pala. Opo, sir. Sige, maraming salamat. Merry Christmas and may God bless everyone. Thank you. Mike, nagpaalam na ako, sir. Upload yun, walang putol. Yun po si sir. Nakakatuwa. Hanggang ngayon, hindi pa rin na nakakalimutan ang ka-BTPP. Oh. Salamat sir sa pagdalaw. God bless. Bye-bye.
Ayon si Sir.
Hi, Pe.
Hello.
Kumusta na?
Okay lang. Hi, Sir.
Mike, kaway ka, Mike. Sa mga 5-star RC cars.
Oo, hi.
Parang kailan lang, ano? Pabilis ng panahon.
Kaya na ako, kaya na kayo. Ayan, mga kasamahan ko. Mga legend sa Cavite. Mga RC cars, mga ka-RC. Ito sila, nakain lang muna kami, ha?
Mga nakaupo
lang. Oo. Na... Pwede rin po. Naghanda si PD. Maganda to sa ating
ng mga...
Sir, ayos yung mga?
Yes, sir.
Dito to sa video.
Video.
Yeah. Ayan, sir. Sir, salamat sa pagtulong ninyo sa akin sa mga oras na kailangan ko ng tulong. Talagang nangangahulugan ito ng maraming oras na mag-uukol ka ng oras sa iyong abalang araw para tulungan akong makuha ito ng tama. Napakalaki ng iyong mga ideya, sir. At isa pa, sir, ang pagtatrabaho para sa isang taong may kasanayan sa pamumuno tulad ninyo ay isang kahangahangang karanasan. Marami na kayong itinuro sa akin sa paglipas ng mga taon at gusto kong pasalamatan kayo para diyan. Kaya naman, ngayon, napakaaga pa man din, sir, General Rodel Orden Sermonya, sir. Para sa Senado, sir, #relentless outstanding service. Mabuhay po kayo!